Hi, in this video I will show you how to use the Photolapse script to create photolapses like this one. We will create two photolapses. I will first show you how to create a basic photolapse with position and scale alignment, and then we will see a more advanced example on which the images will also be aligned in the rotation. So let's start with the first example, and the first step is to import our images. So the images must have a common object or subject. I will drag the images to a new folder, and I will create a composition by clicking this button. So set your dimensions here and your frame rate. I will move this outside of the folder, and I will drag all of the images inside the composition. As you can see, the scaling is not right, but this doesn't matter. The script will handle this with no problem. So the next step is to select all the images and click the Select Images button. But before I do that, I will quickly go to settings and disable the help tips for this video so I don't see any alerts with instructions on how to use it. So select all the images and click this button. So on this stage of the process, we need to create some masks. So we will create one mask for every image. The mask has to be very basic, so it's best to use these common shapes like the rectangle or the ellipse, or you can make a simple shape with the pen tool. In this example, we will mask the tennis ball for each image. So every image I have here has a tennis ball in it. And for this example, I'm going to use the ellipse tool. Now, I'm sure you know how to create a mask. However, there are some tips I'm going to show you so you can speed up the process by a lot. So instead of clicking and dragging here, I will click and drag from the middle of the object. So I'm clicking and dragging, and right away you notice I cannot see the image anymore. So while still dragging, I will tap the N key. So now I can see the image while creating the mask. So while still dragging, I will hit Ctrl and Shift and keep holding those buttons, and I will make the mask. Now, if the mask is not centered, I will also hold the space button so I can move the mask while I'm creating it. And I release every button and I go to the next image by hitting this button. I find the tennis ball, and from the middle I click and drag, Ctrl Shift, I hit N, and I can hold the spacebar to realign it, and this is more than fine. Next, I zoom out, I click and drag, I hit N once, Ctrl Shift, I hold those, and with the spacebar I move it. Next one. So once you do 3, 4, 5 masks, you will really get the hang of it. Now, I will speed up the process, but this doesn't really take that long. Now, this is the last image. I'm creating the ellipse and I hit next. So now all of the masks are going to be processed by the script. And if I fit this to the screen, I can now play the photolapse. Now, this step is completely optional. You can click Finalize at any time so you can create your final photolapse. But on this stage, you can change the duration and the order of your images. Let me show you how it's done. So, right now, the animation I think is fine, but let's speed this up to see how it looks. So, we will go to Settings, and here you will see duration of each image in frames. So, now every image is 3 frames, so I will make it 1 frame. I hit close, and as you can see, it became shorter. So I will play this, and it's much faster. I will go back again, and I will set it to 4, and now it's much slower. Let's set it to 3, I think it's the best option here. Now, let's see how we can change the order. If you want the reverse order of the images, let me close all the masks, and I can select all of the images they are between the Photolapse end and Photolapse start layers. So I select all of those and I can click this button. So now they are all reversed. So the last became first, the first last, and everything in between changed. So if I play now, I think I will stick to this. So also you can move any image to any other place you want. So let's say this image, I want it to appear before this image. So I go here and I see it's layer number 22. So I go to the layer 22 and I move it down. So if you haven't noticed, the images appear from bottom to top. So the last layer is the first image of the Photolapse and the first layer is the last image of the Photolapse. So let's do this again. So I will find an image, let's say this one. So this is layer number 13. I will get this layer and let's see where I want to move it. I want to move it here. So to layer number 23. So 13 goes to 23. I get 13 and I move it below 23. So this becomes 23. And I play the animation to see how it looks. So once you're happy with your animation, you can click finalize. But keep in mind, you cannot change any of the order after you click finalize. You will have to do it manually. So I'm happy with how it looks, so I will click finalize. And this is it. Now, once the Photolapse has been finalized, you will see a new layer has been created, Photolapse controller. Every image is parented to this layer. So I can move this layer to anywhere I want and the Photolapse will play there. Now, the most powerful feature of Photolapse is the animation. If you open up this layer and you go to effects, you have position, scale and rotation effects. Animating these three is very easy and it will make your Photolapse unique. So let's see how it's done. I will use the rotation and I will click to make a keyframe. Go at the end. And I will set a new keyframe to one rotation. So let's play this. And as you can see, each image is rotated just a little bit more from the previous image. So with these three effects, you can make your images act like particles. Now let's go to the second Photolapse. For this one, I will use some images with portraits of people from the Photolapse that you saw in the introduction. So I will import the images. Let's make a new folder. Let's make a new composition. And I will make this vertical. And okay, I will get this out of here and I will drag all the images inside the composition. The images are already selected, so I select images. Now, what's different in this example is that we will also align the images in the rotation. So the first image is ready to be masked. So I will use the right eye from every person as the common subject. And I will again use the ellipse. So again, click and drag, Control Shift N, and I align it with the pupil. Now, to align the images in the rotation, you will have to create a second mask with the pen tool. So I will get the pen tool and I will make a very simple 2-point mask. And with this mask, I'm defining a horizontal line. You could, of course, define a vertical line or any line, as long as it is consistent with every other image you create a rotation mask. So if I define a horizontal line on this image, I cannot define a vertical line on another image. I will have to stick with the horizontal lines. So this image seems fine, so we'll go to the next one. And I will do the same. I take the ellipse tool, Control Shift N, and it's perfect. So I get the pen tool, click and click. And again, the rotation mask must be a 2-point mask. Now, you don't have to align every image on the rotation. If an image is completely straight, you just create one mask, and that is your subject's mask. One thing I haven't mentioned is that if you want to go to the previous image in case you made the mistake, you can click this button. Also, you can click any image you want and hit the next button, and the script will automatically solo that image for you to mask. And another shortcut is to right-click these buttons. So if you right-click the next button, you will mask the next image that doesn't have a mask. So I'm now in layer 10, and the next image seems to be layer 4. So if I right-click here, I go to layer 4. Now, you will notice something weird is happening, but let's play the animation. And as you can see, the rotation is a bit off. So some of the images are straight and some of the images are rotated. Now, this is normal and it happens because the script cannot know if the line you drew is horizontal or vertical. So you will have to click this button a few times until every image is straight. And if I play the animation, now it looks much better. So everything looks fine for me, so I will click Finalize. Now, in case your images are still not completely straight, just select the Photolapse controller, go to Effect Controls, and play with the offset. So this offset only affects the images that have a rotation mask, so you can fine-tune your rotation in case the line you chose was not completely horizontal or vertical. And that's it. You can use these three effects like we did before, and let's do it on the scale this time. So I will set the keyframe here, and let's double click on the slider so we can see it better in the timeline. And I will create a scale down effect. You can also change the scale of the Photolapse controller just to zoom out the whole Photolapse, and this is the result. And if you combine all these three effects, you can get some very interesting results. Thank you for watching.